Hey folks, if you're new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button.
When I searched for a solar phone charger on Temu, this is what popped up. So we're gonna check this thing out. Now, I don't know how long it takes to charge this thing because I've actually had it in this room here and it gets really sunny in here. And I don't know if you can see it, the green light on this thing is already going. So anyway, I'm just gonna unbox this real quick. We'll take a look at it and then we'll go into the whole charging thing. All right, unboxed. This thing's got a little bit of weight to it, so it feels pretty solid. And you can see the green light is already on here where it's been charging. And right here, you can see it's got your little clip there, so you can hang that onto something maybe. And an added bonus, this thing actually has a compass on it. Since this little charger's been in the room that gets a lot of sunlight, and it's been charging a little bit, I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the flashlight. All right, the power button on this thing is not super easy to find. I looked everywhere on this. I thought there'd be a switch or something. Well, there is. If you look it up, there's a power switch right there. It shows it in the instructions. Glad I had those instructions, because I'm about half blind without my reading glasses. So hit this twice and the light comes on. And I'm not gonna look directly in it, but that's a pretty good flashlight. So solar powered flashlight right there.
It was a night of fright.
Okay, I just discovered, turn this on, you hit the button twice. Okay, once it's on, you hit it again and it goes into flashing mode. You hit it again and it goes into SOS mode. Hit it a third time, it goes back into regular old flashlight. Hit it twice, turns off. It's got a little flip here on the back. Open that up and you see your USB charging there. You got 1, 2, and 3. I've got it plugged in now and it is charging a little bit. So we're gonna make sure this is completely charged before we try to charge a phone. Plugging this phone into the solar charger to charge for the night. And we're just gonna see if this thing will charge it all the way up. You can see it's pretty low right now. Let's see what happens. Lights come on there to show you how much power is in there. So got her hooked up. And hopefully it'll just charge it completely up. All right, I forgot to film my phone whenever I checked it in the morning, but it only got it up to 87%. So it went from like 20% to 87%. So that's not great. Okay, so I hooked it up to an iPad and it was 7:50 a.m. and it was at 60%. And then I checked it again at 10:37 a.m. and it had gotten it up to 97%. And the thing I thought was kind of interesting is the charger itself still had a lot of life on it, it looked like. Still had some bars. Okay, so this thing is completely dead now. I let the flashlight completely run it out. And I'm gonna set it out here in the sun and see how long it takes it to fully charge it. So here we go. Okay, this has been out in the sun for about 2 hours now. And I pushed the button to test it. And it shows it's got one bar, okay? So for 2 hours, it did not charge very much. I can say this though, it's completely dead. But the flashlight does come on now, so it did charge some. I guess just not enough to currently charge a cell phone. So I'm gonna leave it out here in the sun for a little bit longer, a couple more hours. I should get a couple more hours of sunlight out here and see if it charges up any better. It is a little overcast today, but I let this thing sit out for another probably hour and a half, and you can see it's still just on one blue dot. So it doesn't charge really fast out in the sun. Maybe if there's really hardcore direct sunlight on it, it might charge better. But anyway, just having it outside ain't that great. From what I can tell, this thing doesn't advertise any kind of durability or anything, but it feels kind of durable. It's got like these bumper sides on it. So anyway, I'm just gonna give it a little bit of a durability test, but I don't think you're gonna have much problem with that. So here we are outside. This is concrete, throwing it up in the air, boom, okay. Let's just see if it cracked anything. Compass is still intact, and I doubt anybody's gonna drop it any harder than that. I'm just intentionally trying to tear this thing up. And let's just see. Looks like that green light's still on, so that means it's charging from the sun right now. All right, I had a chance to test this thing out. What do I think about it? Okay, solar charging didn't seem that great. Maybe I didn't charge it correctly. I don't know, but I'm just telling you, as a layperson, stuck it out in the sun, didn't seem to do a great job charging. It did charge up enough to use the flashlight. Then when I put it inside fluorescent lighting, it seemed to charge up pretty quick, about 3 hours. Now you plug this into a wall, charge. It seems to charge in about an hour, maybe an hour and 15 minutes from dead maybe. And
Anyway, so I just kind of give it a vague testing. Now, it did charge an iPad and an iPhone, and it seemed in a reasonable amount of time, just like charging, seemed about like charging it with just a standard wall plug. Not as good as maybe the modern quick iPhone chargers, but it did seem to charge fairly quickly, so I am satisfied with that. As far as having this out in the sun and charging up a phone, which was kind of my thoughts, you know, if you know you ever run out of gas, you know, there's no gasoline or no power, you know, you're off the grid, whatever, is this thing going to do it? Maybe in a very slow amount of time, I think. Or maybe I didn't use it correctly. If you think I didn't use it correctly, throw that down in the comments. But folks, you can't beat the price. So around $8, seven something on Temu. So I encourage you to check one of these out. Seems like a nice little thing to, you know, a little power bank. You know, it's got the flashlight on it that a lot of people told me seemed very bright to them, and it was super bright to me, I thought. You got a accurate, on this one, it's got a nice accurate compass on it. Seemed to match up pretty close to my iPhone's compass. And, you know, it's compact. So you've got solar charging right here in the palm of your hands, which I think is pretty cool. A lot of people thought this was a cell phone whenever I had it out. So it's got a decent design. All right, folks, if you want to check one of these out, just look on Temu. I will have an Amazon link for a very similar one. I think it may even be the same one. I'm not really sure. It looks very identical to this, but it goes by a different name. So maybe multiple companies are buying these and putting their own names on it. So anyway, there will be an Amazon link in the description and also in the comments if you want to check one that's very similar or maybe the same one out.